Streaming from your computer and from all over the internet, this is All Andy Alfred on Clay Fan 2 3. And now, your host for All Andy Alfred, Andy Alfred.
We live like rock stars, dance on every bar.
Not there anymore.
We are out of things.
Summer look.
They say just grow up, but they don't know us. We don't give a fuck, and we're never gonna change. Stay, oh, just stay forever. Stay, if you stay forever, hey, we can stay forever young.
Oh, here's to never ever growing up. Avril Lavigne with our intro music today, but of course you have to play this. Two game sweep for the Tribe! There's a roar in old Motown. Tigers are back and the crowd's going round. This is the year! Sweep of the Tribe! As bless you Tigers, as the Tigers sweep the quick two-game series of the Windians. Bless you God, the Mudheads didn't play last night, but they gotta get back in action tonight. And the Heat and the Pittsburgh Penguins seem to keep on winning. Oh, I love you guys, and welcome in to this new special edition of All Andy Alfred. Of course, you're watching this right here on Clay Fan 2, 3. I am your host, Andy Alfred, and yes, I have a new haircut. There's no more hair up here. This is the summer look, of course. Keeping it nice and trim and keeps my head nice and cool. But of course, in about 2 weeks, this is not going to be the same. I look like I'm bald, of course, but on the other hand, a quick two-game series sweep of the Tribe was awesome! As the Tigers were a winner last night, we're going to recap that, and as well as preview the series for the Tigers and the Indians coming up as they get ready to do battle, going on the opposite ends of the country, Detroit going back home, and Cleveland headed over to Beamtown. Well, last night, it was a long game, I'll just say the least. The Tigers picking up the win 11-7. Justin Verlander had a little bit of a struggle in the first half of the game until we had that first rain delay. It was close. It was close for Verlander. He gets the win. He goes to 5-4 with a 3.66 ERA. Yomaldo Jimenez gets the loss. He got rocked in the beginning, and David Huff had to come in relief. And Jimenez gets the loss. He goes to 3-3 with a 6.04 ERA. Miguel Cabrera on a weird home run. It kind of looked like off the old Jose Canseco home run that went off his head, where Michael Bourne had it in his glove, and it went off the railing and into the seats for a home run at Progressive Field. Carlos Santana is eighth. Johnny Gomes is Gomes homered for Cleveland, his fifth, in front of 16,562. Game time, 3 hours and 30 minutes, plus an hour and 50-minute rain delay. We had an hour and 1 minute rain delay, and then we had a 49-minute rain delay after that. The game did not end until about almost 1 o'clock in the morning. And, oh, baby. Oh, it almost came down to the end. If you saw my Facebook post, Papa Grande came into the ninth inning, and I was literally... Oh. And I have some choice words for the Cleveland commentators that I was watching the game about last night. So stick around, you'll listen to what I have to say. Other notable games in the MLB yesterday. Atlanta was a winner 8-3 over the Minnesota Twins. Cincinnati 7, the Mets 4. The Dodgers were a winner 9-2 over the Milwaukee Brewers. That was a blowout of a game, to say the least. It got out of hand after the second inning. It was just a blowout. That game was a blowout. I got the chance to watch that. Texas was a winner 3-1 over Oakland. Arizona 1, Colorado 4. The Washington Nationals were a winner 2-1 over the San Francisco Giants. Toronto was a winner 4-3 over Tampa Bay. Jose Bautista with the walk-off winner. Pittsburgh was a winner 1-0. They're playing this afternoon right now. It's Pittsburgh 4, the Cubbies 1. That's in the top half of the fifth inning. Baltimore 6, the Yankees 3. The Angels were a winner 7-1 over the Seattle Mariners. Philadelphia 3, the Miami Marlins 0. Boston was a winner 6-2 over the Chicago White Sox. Houston 3, Kansas City 1, St. Louis 5, San Diego 3. Now looking at the AL Central standings, this is what the Central standings look like going into today's play. Cleveland leads the division. They are 26-19, 6-4 in their last 10 games. The Detroit Tigers are in second place, half game out of first place. They are 25-19, 5-5 in their last 10. Kansas City is at 21-22. Four games out, 3-7 in their last 10. Chicago is in fourth place. They are 21-24. Five games out, 6-4 in their last 10. And they're starting to pick it up their pace just a little bit. And Minnesota rounds out the division. They're 18-25. Seven games out, 1-9 in their last 10. And this is not a good time for the Tigers to play the Minnesota Twins. That's who they open up with this quick four-game series for them before they host the Pittsburgh Pirates on Monday and Tuesday. Diamond on the Hill on Thursday for tonight for the Minnesota Twins. He's 3-4 with a 4.99 ERA. He'll take on Rick Porcello, who is 2-2 with a 5.292 ERA. Game time 7:08 on FSN Detroit, or if you have it in your area, it could be on MLB Network. Friday night, it will be Sanchez on the hill for Detroit. He is 4-4 with a 2.75 ERA. He'll take on DeNuno, who is getting his first start of the season for Minnesota. No record and no ERA. Carrera will start on Saturday. That game on Fox. It'll be Carrera 4-4 with a 3.90 ERA. He'll take on Doug Fister. Excuse me, I had something in my throat there. Who's 5-1 with a 3.62 ERA. Pelfrey will start on Sunday for the concluding game of the series for Minnesota. He's 3-4 with a 6.69 ERA. He'll take on Max Scherzer, who is 6-0. With a 3.61 ERA. All games you can watch on FSN Detroit, excluding the game on Saturday, because that game is on national television. On the opposite end of the spectrum, the Cleveland Indians now hit the road for a big series against the Boston Red Sox in Beantown. Starting tonight, it'll be on MLB Network. You can watch it. It's a Thursday night game. Zach McAllister on the hill. He's 3-3 with a 2.65 ERA. He'll take out Ryan Dempster, who is 2-4 with a 4.27 ERA. Game time 7:10 on STO or MLB Network if you have it. Friday will be Justin Masterson on the hill. He's 7-2 with a 2.83 ERA. He'll take on John Lackey, who's 2-4 with a 3.31 ERA. Saturday, 1:35 start time. Kazmir on the hill for Cleveland. He's 2-2 with a 6.35 ERA. He'll take on John Lester, who's looking lights out. He could be the front runner in the AL for the Cy Young, in my opinion. 6-1 with a 3.15 ERA. And then the concluding game on Sunday will be Corey Kluber, who is 3-3 with a 5.19 ERA. He'll take on Dumont, who's 3-2 with a 5.61 ERA. All games you can watch on Fox Sports Time, Ohio, or if you have it for tonight's game, it'll be on MLB Network. Well, I wanted to save this for later, but I have to get into this right now. I was watching the coverage last night of the Tigers and Indians game on Sports Time Ohio. As most of you know, I like watching Sports Time Ohio to watch Chuck Galletti and Chuck's Last Call, All Bets Are Off with Bruce Drennan, the Golf Zone with Jimmy Hanlon. I also like watching the coverage for the Indians. Matt and Rick basically called Miguel Cabrera a prima donna. Didn't look like he wanted to play. Who would want to play after an hour and 2 minute rain delay and then have to come back up, strike out, ground out, and then 45 minutes later have to get caught in another rain delay and then hit a home run right afterwards? Matt and Rick are something else. I thought Ken the Hawk Harrelson was bad. But Matt and Rick are horrible, I'll say that at least. The only prima donna on Sports Time Ohio is Al Pawlowski. I'll admit that right now. It is pathetic. Rick Manning calling Miguel Cabrera not wanting to play the game, being 100% in the game. When were you ever perfect in baseball, Matt and Rick? And Matt Underwood, you said you were there in 1995. What were you? Where were you in 1995? Were you selling peanuts? Were you selling bootleg t-shirts outside the stadium? No, you weren't in the broadcast booth. But you could say that you were in the booth watching the 95 team of Albert Bell, Jim Thome, Kenny Lofton, Oral Hershiser, Dennis Martinez. I remember those days. Those were good days. What else is good days? Hopefully, the Mudhens can finally get some wins. We're going to preview the series. They get started back up tonight in Gwinnett in this big four-game set against the Gwinnett Braves. It will be Garcia on the hill. He's 1-4 with a 5.20 ERA. Rodriguez for Gwinnett. He's 2-3 with a 5.77 ERA. Game time tonight at 6:05 on 1230 WCWA. It's an iHeart radio station, so you can listen to it anywhere around the country. Friday will be Alvarez on the hill for Toledo. He's 4-2 with a 1.9 ERA. Gwinnett will now throw out, it was a change made last night. It will be Beachy on the hill for Gwinnett. He has no starting record, no ERA. It will be very interesting. He just gets called up from Double A, the Double A prospect of the Atlanta Brave organization. Saturday will be Sean Hill on the hill. He's 0-4 with a 4.92 ERA. He'll take on Gil Martin, who's 2-3 with a 4.23 ERA. And the concluding game on Sunday will be Hankins on the hill. Very good pitcher for the Mudhens. 1-2 with a 2.51 ERA. He'll take on Corona, who is 2-3 with a 3.64 ERA. You can listen to all the games on 1230 WCWA with Jim Weber. Looking at the IL West standings, this is what it looks like. The Mudhens are still in the bottom, but Indianapolis leads the division. They're 32-15, 6-4 in their last 10. Columbus is in second place with a 28-18 record, 3.5 out, 8-2 in their last 10. They're going to make a run right now for the IL West first place position. Louisville is in third. They're 23-23, 8.5 out, 6-4 in the last 10. And of course, with the Mudheads not playing yesterday, the record still stays the same at 15-32. 17 games out, 5-5 in the last 10. I was at stake last night, Phil! You enjoyed sleeping in your bed? Your ass is gonna get canned! Follow the show at Twitter. The thing is all Andy Alfred. That's all A-L-L-A-N-D-Y. A-L-F-R-E-D. And follow it with the hashtag Fire Phil Nevin. Fire Phil Nevin. Unbelievable. I still can't believe he still has a position in the job. Larry Parrish, like I said, is in single A. Why don't we just flip him? That's what Nevin does. He can do that. He used to be a single-A coach. But I digress. NHL playoffs for you. Pittsburgh was a dominant winner last night, 7-3 over the Ottawa Senators. They take a commanding 3-1 series lead going back to Pittsburgh on Friday. Tonight it will be the Boston Bruins. Could end the series tonight against the New York Rangers. Boston has a 3-0 series lead, game time 7 o'clock on CNBC. Also at 8 o'clock tonight, it will be Game 4, the Western Conference Semifinals between the Chicago Blackhawks and the Detroit Red Wings. Detroit has a series lead 2-1, and this is Game 4, 8 o'clock start time on NBC Sports Network, or if you have it, CBC. Watch it on CBC, NBC Sports Network. The only thing on NBC Sports Network that's good is the Dan Patrick Show. Gotta admit that. Also, the late game tonight, San Jose taking on L.A. San Jose with the lead in that series, 10:30 start time on NBC Sports Network. Well, I have to say this. The Miami Heat proved again that they'll probably be the champions of the world as they won last night 103-102 in overtime on a last-minute layup by you-know-who, LeBron James. Unbelievable. No games tonight in the NBA playoffs. It will start back up Friday night at 8 o'clock as San Antonio hits the road to take on Memphis. 8 o'clock start time on ESPN. Recommendations for you today. Don't forget, go out and pick up Michael Bublé's new album, To Be Loved. It's a great album. Go pick it up. Go get a million copies. Number 5 still on the Billboard chart. We'll find out by the end of this week if it will still stay number 5, of course. Great songs. He is the Frank Sinatra of our time. Michael Bublé, great artist. Go see him. He'll be at the Q, and he'll be at the Palace of Auburn Shields. Check out Ticketmaster.com. Also, don't forget, right here, these teeth were done by Dr. Juhari in Fisher's office with one location in Rossford, Ohio. Dr. Z has been doing an awesome job. He took out my wisdom teeth. I'll be going next Tuesday to get some touch-up work done and so on and so forth. Call, make an appointment. The phone number is 419-666-3327. That's 419-666-3327 or at zfdentist.com. Also for you guys, I want to give a shout out to my haircut person from Great Clips. I walked right in, sat right down, and I was done in about 10 minutes with this nice haircut. It's the summer look. That means the summer is finally here. Next week on our next week shows will look like this. We will not have a show on Monday, of course, for it being the holiday of Memorial Day. We'll pay homage to those. We'll have a special edition of All Andy Alfred on Monday for you guys, so I hope you guys enjoy it. We're looking to shoot up, get a couple more interviews for next week, especially with the Mudhens getting ready to come back home after the homestand. We'll see what they can do. We'll see if we can get Lucas back in to pick his brain about the NBA playoffs and also with the NHL playoffs. And we're also going to get Nick DeVera from Rational Pastimes to come back into the studio and talk to us about some of the calls and some of the issues dealing with the Dodgers and so on and so forth. So stick with us. We have a whole summer left to go here on All Andy Alfred. I am Andy Alfred, and I hope you have a terrific rest of the day. Enjoy it. Even though it's raining outside here in downtown Toledo, Ohio, it is going to be a very interesting day, to say the least. But until tomorrow, I will see you all again on Friday. Our Friday edition will be Throwback Friday, so you'll hear something interesting as the intro music. But remember, I'm pulling for you. We are all in this together, and especially the teams behind me. Go, Tigers, keep the winning track going. And come on, Cabby, keep that home run streak going. Because we swept the Tribe! And to you at home, victory is sweetest when you have tasted defeat. Have a nice night, everybody. And I'll see you tomorrow for our Friday edition of All Andy Alfred. I love you guys. We'll be dancing till dawn. One more Tiger win. Love you guys.